वेलकम टू आयरन एंड स्टील मेकिंग कोर्स लेक्चर 4 टॉपिक कोक मेकिंग। लेट मी गिव यू द ब्रीफ आइडिया अबाउट कोक मेकिंग प्रोसेस। नाउ वन नीड टू नो एट दिस स्टेज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कोल एंड चारकोल। द चारकोल इज मेड अप ऑफ बर्निंग द वुड फ्रॉम द ट्रीज विच हैज high ash content which evolves and it is not strong, it is too soft. And another part is coal. The coal is natural coal. The natural coal is abundant in the earth crust, as you see in Singareni coal mines. So abundant natural coal is available. That particular natural coal is composed of many elements such as hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, other materials, many things. And what all other properties of natural coal? Coal means natural coal. The charcoal is this one. One need to differentiate at this stage. Now let us know more about natural coal. What are the other properties of natural coal? Is that the amount of volatile matter are easy to volatile. That particular matter is very high in the case of natural coal. Even the ash content also very high, so that it leads to the large volume of slag produced during the pig iron production of blast furnace. Fixed carbon, that means low calorific value is having, and moisture content is very high. Naturally occurring coal is having these properties, and it is fragile in the nature, easy to break, easy to brittle. So which is you cannot shift it, you cannot transport to till the blast furnace location. There will be a so much loss of the coal material, and it is too dense. It is just like odd stone. So from if it is like this, the air during the blast furnace iron making, the air blast is sent through the coal. So it is, since it is too dense, there is no porous in between these particles, it is difficult to allow the penetration of air blast, as the name suggests, blast furnace. Blast, you pause. Hence, it is required that the coal supposed to be choosing for the blast furnace iron making supposed to be very strong. Why it need to be very strong? Because from the bottom or earth zone of blast furnace till 25 meter height, this particular coal is lying. Over this, iron ore and limestone is lying. It is the base material. We call it as a burden material. It should be strong. Therefore, the coke is made from the coal. Now, this particular coke ore is introduced at this particular blast furnace pig iron production. You need to know more about coke. The idea about the coal and charcoal is cleared here, and natural coal properties is cleared. What is required? This is required. Now you need to make coke. Coke has all these properties: low volatile matter, low ash content, coke. So you need to make, then you call it as a coke. It has other name called metallurgical coal, not natural coal. Metallurgical coal is suitable for blast furnace. It is strong and less ash content, which is made up of natural coal only. Mainly anthracite grade of coal is suitable for making coke. This one need to know. Now coming to the next point, the selecting, how do you select this particular coal for coke making? One is chemical characteristics of coal. So what are the chemical characteristics? How do you judge? The first method is proximate analysis. This is metallurgical analysis of coal, the first step. There were labs existing in the olden metallurgical departments. It is isolated, it is been included in the mineral processing, non-ferrous and ferrous mineral processing laboratory. These things are included. What is proximate analysis? Knowing or calculating the amount of moisture, amount of ash and volatile matter, fixed carbon, while eating coal you calculate all these particular things. For example, if ash content is more, even 1% ash if existing in the coal, you need to increase silica to balance it around 7%. It is obvious that it affects the iron productivity by 3%. One example, if volatile matter is low by conversion of natural coal into metallurgical coal or coke, it is higher amount of coke. If low volatile matter of natural coal is made, so that means it is higher amount of coke properties are having. So desirable thing is the volatile matter supposed to be optimum in between 18 to 38%. Another chemical characteristics of coal is calculated by ultimate analysis. What is ultimate analysis? Determining chemical components in the natural coal in terms of hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, sulfur content using a spectroscopy technique, and it is been chosen the environment of dry environment. Why do you need to choose dry environment? To avoid inclusion of hydrogen and oxygen. Your purpose is, what is the amount of hydrogen and oxygen in the natural coal? If it is exposed to air or water, so obviously these things, hydrogen and oxygen includes, it shows higher oxygen and hydrogen content. So that is why you avoid this particular water based method, wet based method. You choose dry based method. Another characteristics is reflectance of coal, or you call it as a rank of coal. It is nothing but microscopic examination, just like spectroscopy component. It is microscopic examination of this particular natural coal is called a grade of coal, vitrinite coal. Within the anthracite grade of coal, there is a vitrinite coal. Using the, it has been compared with the reference of vitrinite coal using special reflectance microscope. You give rank 1, rank 2, rank 3. You choose rank 1 coal. Now coming to the other characteristics of coal. What are other characteristics? Caking property. It should have caking property. All the coals, it undergoes while eating chemical changes, but it also inherently undergoes physical change. These particular inducial coal particles mix together while eating form a cake nature. That particular cake nature is more, it depends upon the volatile matter. If volatile matter is more, it will be sticky type, more free type, cake type coal, which is not suitable. One need to choose, justify. Another thing is of another characteristic of coal is free swelling index. Why you are calling it as a free? It is not restricted with any environment or tool. That is nothing but free swelling index. And how do you measure the increase of volume of that particular coal particles when it is heated without any external application, external shaping, external restrictions? If FSI shortcut is lowest as observed for anthracite coal, which does not fuse so easily, which will not swell, so these things are suitable. And another characteristic is odd groove grindability index. When you grind it and using mesh of 200 mesh size, when you observe the particles remaining in the mesh and fall from the mesh, it is calculated and suggested that odd groove index less than 45 after falling from the 200 mesh screen. If it is less than 45 particles which are fall down from the mesh, which are called odd coal particles. If it is greater than 55 micron size, you call it as a soft coal. Optimum value of HGI for selection of coal to for making coke supposed to be 50 to 52. And another characteristic is fluidity. During coke making process, the process is called carbonization of coal to convert into the coke. The first step is softening. It softens and swelling occurs. After swelling, semi-plastic is nothing but partially odd and completely plastic. Then it is coke, which is solidified and strong. The corresponding video also explaining about coke making just few minutes back. And during this particular coke making, the fluid flow plays an important role. The softening, swelling, it is nothing but flowing. There are some non-melting fractions, components, features, material also combined with the coal. It is nothing but it is involved. If it is more non-melting fractions, the fluidity will be low. If it is low grade coal, soft coal, the fluidity will be very less. That is one point. Now one need to know about what actually the these are the characteristics and what is raw material for coke, that is coal, and which type of coal. Let us know the history behind the coal, how this particular natural coal is made up of. Initially it is the vegetable matter which is submerged in the earth, and it is continuously exposing, it is decomposing within the earth. There is a moisture in the atmosphere, there is air, and there is temperature and pressure changes because of geological actions, season by season. It is degrades, it decomposes like this. Initially we call it as a peat, vegetable matter, vegetable waste, peat coal. Then after, under the application of pressure and temperature time as it has been proceeding, it is called a lignite coal, and after that sub-bituminous, bituminous and anthracite. Carbon content is slowly increases, carbonation material it becomes. Initially it is low. Finally, when it is been decomposed completely with this particular conditions, very high carbon content. This is the below picture gives an idea about how the coal particles, naturally occurring coal, looks like. Taking this particular natural coal using a modern blast furnace coke making method, that particular coke looks like this. Less ash content, more strong, and compared to coal. One need to know about what are the methods are existing for making coke from the coal. For iron making, blast furnace pig iron production, the fuel is coke. That particular coke supposed to be metallurgical coal. It should have metallurgical characteristics such as low ash content, low volatile matter, strong. Also, it is called coking coal. Metallurgical coal, coking coal, and coke are synonyms. But as adjectives, you explain like this. And coke making process in old method, it involves, it is nothing but carbonization of coal. Under the application of high temperature and pressure, as the time is proceeding, the ash content, volatile matter in the closed atmosphere, in the vacuum, we convert the coal into the coke. It involves the subjection of heat in absence of air. That is why vacuum chosen, so that the coal will be carbonaceous, more carbon content, less ash content, volatile free, strong and porous it becomes. Then you call it as a coke. This particular coke is right fuel for blast furnace pig iron production. This was the old method. In the modern coke making steps, there are coke oven batteries and as well as BHEV coke oven batteries. Many instruments and tools are evolved, developed. The series of steps followed for making coke. Initially, you wash out so that any foreign particles associated with the coal goes out. Then you blend it is nothing but mixing together. The mixing strength, mixing ratio is categorized. Primary coking coal, initially this much amount of material is mixed, and medium coking coal, if it is this much mixing percentage is done, if it is 10 to 20% only mixed, you call it as a weak coking coal under the blending. After that, dehydration. All the volatile matter supposed to be escaped, removed. Then after stamp charging, you give a specific shape using coke oven battery box, compressed and charged for carbonization, subjecting to the higher temperature around 1100 degree Celsius temperature. Further, it is continued to carbonization around 4 hours or 8 hours. Finally, that particular product is called coke after the time intervals. This particular coke need to have certain characteristics. It has undergone to calculation of techniques, that is reflectance of vitrinate coal. If this particular coke is categorized as a vitrinate coal, the rank of that particular coal supposed to be in between 1.15 to 1.25. And another value is fluidity of that particular coal. If you need to say good coke is made, the coal supposed to be having 250 ddppm, dial divisions per minute, which is nothing but 100 times rotational speed. Another conversion, rotational speed, rotations per minute. This is standard Geissler fluidity units. It has good fluidity, so that you can convert the coal into the after series of steps softening and semi plastic, plastic, then after coke, it should have good fluidity. This number value it should have. Now the conclusion of this particular lecture, natural coal available in the earth crust, whereas charcoal made by burning wood. Natural coal available in the earth crust is one statement, and charcoal is made by burning wood. Is it true or false? Please give your opinion on this particular point.